Nice. What about when we have 0 divided by 0? I know this 2 is undefined, but there could be someone who does the long division and says 0 goes into itself once, because the number goes into itself once. So the answer is 1. What would you say then? Well, in fact, so many of you guys asked me the same question in that previous video. So today, let's address the issue that what is 0 divided by 0? And I am still going to keep this at a third grade level so that everybody can understand. And here we are not doing calculus, right? Here we go. 0 divided by 0. Let's review long division real quick, just like last time. I showed you guys 8 divided by 2 and 2 divided by 8 last time. Today, let's do something different. Let's say 1 divided by 5. And I love long division because it provides you an algorithm to work out division. Here we go. Remember, you always put the first number inside and then the second number on the outside. It's not because how big they are. It's because the first number goes inside, second number goes on the outside for the long division. And then you ask yourself, 5 goes into 1 how many times? Well, 0 times. So you put down 0 here, and then can we continue? Yes. To do so, put down a decimal point here and here, and then you can put a 0 here, because 1 is the same as 1.0. And then you can look at 5 and 10. 5 goes into 10. 2 times, 2 times 5 is 10. Subtract, and then you get the remainder 0. You're done. That's the answer, 0.2. Yay, just like that. So now, here we go. What exactly is 0 divided by 0? Long division again. Here, we will put down the first number inside, and then the second number on the outside. And then let's ask ourselves, what times 0 is equal to 0? Or you can also ask yourself, 0 goes into 0 how many times? 1, maybe, right? Just like what we said earlier. So maybe it's 1. 1 times 0 does give us 0. And then when we subtract, hey, we end up with 0. Just like that, huh? Because the remainder is 0, that means this right here has to be the answer. But wait, what if we do this? Again, 0 inside and this 0 on the outside. But what if you put 0 here? 0 times 0, yes, it's 0. And then if we subtract, we get 0. Huh. So does that mean 0 is also the answer? Could be, right? But wait, how about you do this? Again, 0 inside, and then this 0 on the outside. And let's see, what do you want to try? 17? Okay. If you have 17 times 7 times 0, you get 0. And then if you subtract, hey, you get remainder is 0, so that's the answer, right? In fact, when you do 0 divided by 0, you can end up with infinitely many answers, right? Any numbers. But if you're just looking at this as a computational question, you do not want infinitely many answers. You just want to have 1. So which one do we take to be the answer though? Well, no, we are not going to take any of them. So in this case, 0 divided by 0 is also undefined, meaning we don't have an answer for this right here. So I'll just put it down and box it, just like that. Let me know what you guys think. Again, we are not doing calculus, so please do not say take the limit, blah, 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 blah. But if you guys would like, I will try to think about some lessons for calculus at a third grade level for you guys. But for now, that's it.